यस यस
कैसे?
आना, यस प्लीज
मैम अर्थक्वेक एंड अंडर
सी।
सी वोल्केनिक एरप्शन।
यस मे सी अर्थक्वेक कम अंडर द सी, यस दैट इज कॉल्ड सुनामी, अ लॉन्ग हाई सी वेव। ऑल ऑफ यू लेट्स स्टार्ट राइटिंग द मीनिंग ऑफ सुनामी, बिकॉज द स्पेलिंग इज TSUNAMI। आई एम शेयरिंग द बोर्ड, सो द स्पेलिंग ऑफ दिस वर्ड इज, द वर्ड फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल चैप्टर नंबर 13, नेम ऑफ द चैप्टर इज फायर स्टोन। You start writing in this way. Give today's date. Today is 1st February. So February 1, 2021. Now, the first word here, it is word meaning. Word meaning. G will be there. The first word, because the chapter is based on the story of tsunami, okay, which was occurred on 26 December 2004, and it was a devastating tsunami, taking millions of lives, okay, millions of people became homeless or destitute. That's why it is compulsory to know the meaning of tsunami, and the word is T. It starts from T. T S U N A M I. T here silent. Okay, T here silent. Silent means we will not pronounce T. We will pronounce S U N A M I. Tsunami. Okay, the meaning of this word is a long high sea wave, okay, sea wave caused by an earthquake, caused by an earthquake. All of you, children, mute your mic. Mute your mic. Okay, earthquake. The next word we will write here, destitute. Okay, destitute. D E S. Okay, D E S T I T U T E.
प्रोनाउंसिएशन
क्लास में कोई आर ए नाम से जॉइन किया था कौन क्लास में कोई आर ए नाम से जॉइन यस 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 ही इज अ टीचर ओके एंड ही इज टेकिंग रिकॉर्डिंग सो डियर चिल्ड्रन डोंट स्पीक इन हिंदी प्लीज स्पीक इन इंग्लिश ही इज टेकिंग आवर क्लास रिकॉर्डिंग इज इट क्लियर So be okay. Don't make any noise here. Give me the correct answer of the correct question. Means question, proper answer, and be very disciplined. Please maintain the discipline because he is a sir and teacher, and he is taking a recording for 40 minutes. So destitute. Okay, destitute means write down. Without money, food, or a home. Okay?
हेलो मैम, हेलो मैम, ये क्वेश्चन नंबर 30 है ना?
क्वेश्चन नहीं है मैम, ये तो चैप्टर नंबर 13 है ना।
ओके मैम, हाँ हाँ अभी क्लियर आया ना मेरा स्क्रीन पे।
ओह, और चैप्टर का नाम है फायर स्टोन
जी।
इसमें वर्ड मीनिंग लिखवा रहे हैं
जी मैम।
सो जस्ट यू चूज। Without, ma'am, please mute your mic, ma'am, because it makes a sound. The people, okay, without food or okay, food, money or a home. Okay, children, write down the first word is tsunami, T-S-U-N-A-M-I, tsunami. The second word is destitute, D-E-S-T-I-T-U-T-E, destitute. The people without food, money or a home. It means those who lost everything in any devastation, in any destruction, they are called destitute. Okay? I am going to remove it, children. May I erase the board?
Yes, ma'am.
All of you have written?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Yes, ma'am. Okay. Now, the next word we will know about seabed. The next word is seabed. Okay? I think word number 3. Because without knowing the meanings of these words, you will not be able to understand. So, seabed, the bottom of the ocean. No matter how deep. Seabed means the bottom of the ocean. No matter how deep. Okay. The next word is occasionally. The next word is occasionally. Occasionally means sometimes. Very rare. Occasionally means sometimes. Okay? Sometimes. The next word is churn and cling. The next word is churn and cling. The word number 5. Churn and cling. Churn and cling. The meaning of this word is to throw something. To throw. To throw something. To throw something. T-H-I-N-G. Something. Especially. especially a liquid with great force, especially a liquid with great force. With great force. With great force. Okay. Okay, so children, this one. The next word you write down, Union Territory. May I erase the board?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
All of you have written? Ma'am. Okay, all of you have written?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Well, the next word is Union Territory. Union Territory. It means the state governed by the central government of India. Central Government of India. Okay. Now, the next word is, let's come to the point. It's a Champagne. The next word is Champagne. Champen. Okay, Champagne. A group of natives who live in the Nicobar Island. Okay, a group of natives who live in the Nicobar Islands. Andaman and Nicobar. Do you know this is Union Territory? Andaman and Nicobar, the island?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So that, yes, this Nicobar. Okay, fine. Nicobar Islands. 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 Don't say Island. Okay, islands. Is it clear? Okay. May I erase it, dear children? May I erase
yes,
it?
Yes,
all of you have written?
Yes, ma'am.
Ankit? Ankit, have you written, beta? Okay. Now, let's come to the point. Okay, this is about the story. First of all, the writer, write down the writer of this, the author. Author, writer, both are the similar word. Author of this story is Okay, A in copper, O N. Again, I have to share the board to tell you the correct pronunciation. The word is E O I N. Okay, copper, C O L F E R. But the pronunciation will be O N, O E N, O N copper. Okay, L will be silent here. It is about copper. C-O-F-E-R, L silent. Here he will pronounce O-W, O-N copper. Children, all of you, please pronounce this word with me. O-N copper.
O-N
copper.
O-N copper. O-N copper. Correct? So who is the writer of this story, Firestone? O-N?
O-N copper.
Yes, O-N copper. Good. So let's know about the author also. A very small sketch biography of the author, O-N copper. Let's start writing. Again, I am going to share the board. You have to mention the in this way. About the author, about the author. Is it clear? About the author, you have to mention in this way. And author is O.N. Copper. So we will write O.N. Copper was born on 14th May 1965 in Ireland. Okay. He is an Irish author. He is Irish. Irish means the people who live in Ireland, they are called Irish. The people who live in China, they are Chinese. Okay, the people who live in India, Indian, Japan, Japanese, okay, so Germany, German. So the people who live in their country, they are called in this way. Okay, China people are called Chinese, India's people are called Indian. That in the same way, Ireland people are called Irish. Is it clear? The people who live in Ireland are called Irish. I-R-I-S-H. Okay? An Irish author. Author of children's books. Children's books. He worked as a primary school teacher. Primary school teacher before he became a teacher. Up to here you write down. I don't have enough space here. May I erase it?
Yes, ma'am.
He worked as a primary school teacher before he became a writer. Before he became a writer. WRITER. Single T. Children, don't write the double T there. Single T. WRITER. Writer. Full stop. He is. Continue writing. He is best known for. He is best known for KNOWN. Known for being the author of. He is best known for being the author of the being BEING. Being the author of the, okay, author of the Artemis Fowl series. The spelling is this one. A-R-T-E-M-I-S. Okay? A-R-T-E-M-I-S. Artemis Fowl series. Under inverted comma. Okay? Completed, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes,
now
ma'am.
Now let's come to the point. Let me tell you first of all, what is the story about? Whatever the word meanings you have written, children, these all words are from page number 163. These all words are from page number 163. Only from two paragraphs, we had the 5 to 6 difficult words. Then we have come to know about the author, okay? O.N. Coffer. A very short summary. Short sketch about the author of this story, Firestones, okay, O.N. Coffer. Now let's come to the point, the theme. What is the theme of the story? Theme is the verses, okay, the motto. Why does the author write this story? Okay, how this story will be fruitful for the readers, okay? Does it inspire the children, the readers, the students? So, this is called the theme. The exact meaning of the story. What do you mean by this story? Why do we read the story? And when we find out the answer, that is called the theme. So, the theme of this story is, okay, the theme of this story is as follows. This time I will not write down anything. Okay? This time I will not write down anything. I will just explain. The tsunami of 26 December 2004 left millions dead, homeless, or destitute along the Indian Ocean coastline. Okay? A tsunami generally occurs when the seabed shifts places occasionally, causing earthquake or seaquake. I have already told you what do you mean by tsunami, and the important date is given here, okay, the tsunami, okay, which brought a massive destruction. Massive means a huge destruction. Okay, where it was the date, the fateful date. The fateful means very bad. Okay, the bad, unfortunate day for the people. 26 January 2004. It was a fateful day, date 26 December 2004. When the tsunami occurred, okay, it has taken millions of lives. Okay, millions of people died. and in number of a large number of people became homeless or destitute. Okay, destitute, no money, no food, no home, nothing was left. And this tsunami occurred, okay, along the Indian Ocean coastline. Coastline means the sea areas. Okay, the sea areas. A tsunami generally occurs when the seabed. When and how does tsunami occur? If anybody will ask you, how does tsunami occur? The answer will be, tsunami generally occurs when the seabed, okay, the bottom of the ocean, it shifts places, sometimes occasionally causing earthquake. Okay, occasionally causing earthquake or seaquake. Okay, and when tsunami occurs in the water, in the sea, what does it do? It begins to churn and fling. Okay, very forcefully to start throwing very forcefully the water, maybe 30 feet, 50 feet high, okay, on the sea coast. And the nearby, okay, the inhabitants, the nearby natives are being affected. So the sea begins to churn and fling large volumes of water towards the land. Churn and fling means to throw, especially the liquid, okay, liquid with great force. So water, when the earthquake, okay, occurred in the sea, sea started, okay, means waving up and up, the means maybe 30 feet high, 50 feet high like that, and it throws the water, the sea water, okay, very forcefully towards the land. On 26 December 2004, one of the areas that got badly affected by the tsunami was the Andaman and Nicobar Islands, a union territory of India. Okay, the most affected area was Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Okay, on 26 December 2004, when the tsunami occurred, the most affected area was Andaman and Nicobar Island. As we know that, okay, Andaman and Nicobar is a union territory of India. Union territory, right now you have written the meaning, means, okay, the city, the state, sorry, not the state, governed by, ruled by the central government of India. This is a fictional story about the day of the tsunami. Fictional. It is not a fact. It is not a real story. It's just a fictional story. Okay. About the day of the tsunami as experienced by two boys. Okay. It's a fictional story, not a real story. Two boys. One an islander, the narrator, and the other a champagne boy. Okay, one was the islander. Islander means who lived at Nicobar Island. Okay, means Andaman and Nicobar Island. And the second was the champagne boy. Champagne is a community, okay, group of natives who live in the Nicobar Island. Okay, champagne is a community who lived, it's a tribe. Champagne is the tribe of Andaman and Nicobar Island. So, Champagne boy. Okay, up to here I have completed. What did you learn, okay, through these two paragraphs? What did you learn from these two paragraphs? When was the tsunami occurred?
26 December 2004.
Okay, how many, yes, what means, how many lives had been get destroyed in that tsunami. Millions in the first line, if you will look at your book, in the first line it is given millions dead, homeless or destitute. Okay, what do you mean by destitute?
Without money, food or even.
Okay, the people
without money, food or even.
Okay, how does tsunami occur? How does tsunami occur? Tsunami occurs when the seabed shifts places occasionally. Tsunami generally occurs when the seabed shifts places occasionally, causing earthquake or sea quake. Again, I am going to ask the same question. How does tsunami occur? Hello? There is no reply.
When the seabed shift places
occasionally, causing earthquake.
Yes, ma'am.
Children, all of you, okay, reply the answer together. Tsunami generally occurs children speak with me a tsunami generally occurs when the seabed shifts places occasionally. Causing earthquake or sea quake. Okay. Now there were two characters in this story. One was the champagne boy. Then who was the another one? There were two boys in this story. There are two characters. One was the champagne boy. Then who was the another one?
Islander.
The narrator. Islander, the narrator himself. Owen Coffer. Do you think it is a real story?
Not story.